StoryBots. Ta-da!
StoryBots presents Great Innovator.
One gloomy night in Menlo Park, Tom Edison said,
"Gee, it's dark."
But then he had a brilliant thought. Electric lights would help a lot. Now others too had tried their best to build a bulb that passed the test, and yet their light would never last. The glowing part burned out too fast.
"I see,"
said Tom.
"I must invent a better, stronger filament."
At first he tried some metal wire, which melted, broke, or caught on fire. So next he tested strips of wood and every single plant he could. He had to char them first, he learned, to make them glow but not get burned. Grasses, reeds, and weeds galore, he tried 6,000 kinds and more. He had some luck with cotton thread, but then he tried bamboo instead. It filled the room with dazzling rays. What's more, it lasted 50 days. And now the light bulb's golden glare is seen in houses everywhere. New York and London, France, Brazil. The bulbs keep getting better still. They light the night when day is done. All thanks to Thomas Edison.
StoryBots presents Great Innovator.
George Washington Carver, a child of a slave, was curious, clever, ambitious, and brave. On a farm where he lived, he was eager to know about all vegetation and what made it grow. He tried to enroll at the neighborhood school, but they said,
"You're not welcome. Tough luck, it's the rule."
"That's crazy," he thought, "but it won't get me down." And he left for a school in a faraway town, where he proved right away he was smart as can be. He later completed a college degree. He became a professor, but wished to do more. So he moved to Tuskegee to work with the poor. He taught how the healthiest crops could be grown, and meanwhile he worked in a lab of his own. He studied all plant life from grasses to spruces. For peanuts, he found over 300 uses. He made peanut pancakes, he made peanut cheeses, elixirs and ointments for fighting diseases, charcoal, linoleum, plastics and glue, hand lotion, soap, even peanut shampoo. He made peanut butter for mixing with jams, and then did more wonders with soybeans and yams. His remarkable talent for flair and invention soon brought him the nation's admiring attention. But praises and fame never went to his head. He was always devoted to learning instead. He never had much, yet he reached for the sky. George Washington Carver was one brilliant guy.
StoryBots presents Great Innovator.
Orville and Wilbur, two brothers named Wright, once dreamed of machines with the power of flight. In a little back room of their bicycle shop, their designing and tinkering just wouldn't stop. They'd study the wings and the motions of birds, while the neighbors would laugh.
What a couple of nerds.
They tested one glider, and then built another.
"We're learning,"
said Wilbur.
"And how?"
said his brother. They both got a bump or a bruise now and then, but they never gave up. They just tried again, till at last they had built something no one had seen. They were ready to test their flying machine. So on a day in December in 1903, near the city of Kitty Hawk down by the sea, they cranked up the engine. And what did it do? It sputtered. It rumbled. Then zoom, off it flew. And that's why today you can hop on a plane to Chicago or Phoenix, Australia or Spain. So whenever you look at an airplane in flight, just remember the tale of two brothers named Wright.
StoryBots presents Great Innovator.
In the days of castles, kings, and knights, a book was something rare. It was made by hand for wealthy folk, with lots of gold to spare. Till a clever man named Gutenberg said,
"That's a shame indeed. If making books was quick and cheap, then everyone could read."
So he launched a secret project in the workshop where he'd hide. And townsfolk often stopped to ask,
"What's going on inside?"
Well, Gutenberg was hard at work with all his expertise. He invented little molds to make his metal ABCs. He'd arrange them in a block of type and smear it all with ink. Then press it down on paper.
Not as easy as you'd think.
For years he toiled and tinkered, till at last he found success. He unveiled his great invention.
"Look, I've made the printing press."
He printed up some school books, which were nice but just a start. But then he made his famous Bible, which were splendid works of art. Ooh. The printing press soon changed the world. Now everyone had books. Not only kings and noblemen, but farmers, maids, and cooks. So today, whenever you enjoy a book or magazine, just remember that it started out with Gutenberg's machine.
Ugh.
presents Right Innovator.
In the land of fedoras and tasty spumoni, there lived a young genius whose name was Marconi. He'd tinker and daydream and read through the day.
Go do something useful,
his father would say. Now, scientists then were already aware that electrical waves could be sent through the air, which soon led his curious brain to inquire, could messages somehow be sent without wire? So he took to his lab and succeeded quite well, with a gadget that set off a faraway bell. He showed it to experts, who told him,
Dear boy, it won't work long distance, it's only a toy.
Now, he could have just put it away on a shelf, but Marconi decided,
I'll see for myself.
It worked, and it transmitted further each day. When he showed it in England, it blew them away. He built them a radio system for ships to stay close in contact on long ocean trips. He then built antennas so strong and gigantic that signals could travel across the Atlantic. He soon became rich and was known far and wide.
Ah, that's my boy,
said his father with pride. And as others built on to his bold innovations, they gave us our popular radio stations. The airwaves are busy, and that's no baloney, because of the brains of Guglielmo Marconi.
Ahoy, lady anchor.
I'm the captain of the boat, and I really like to float on the water,
out on the water.
So put on your sailing vest, grab a life vest, and take a ride on a boat with me. We'll take an ocean liner.
Would you like to go for a ride in my car?
Yes, that sounds fun.
They're in the street
cars.
They're really neat
cars.
They roll around
cars
from town to town. If you've got somewhere to go, there's a thing you ought to know.
Cars.
In the parking lot
cars.
Careful when they're hot
cars.
You can hear them beep
cars.
Hey, that car's a Jeep. Green or purple, red or blue. Maybe there's a car for you. Summer round and summer square. Or hatchback, station wagon or sedan, SUV or minivan.
I'm in a minivan.
Cars.
With license plates.
Cars.
From different states.
Cars.
Race around the track.
Cars.
Take you to school and back. From the mountains to the sea, they'll get you from point A to B.
Cars.
Turn left or right.
Cars.
In day or night.
Cars.
Take you to the lake.
Cars.
Don't forget to break electric, gasoline, or diesel. Faster than a speeding weasel. Push the pedal to the floor. Listen to the engine roar.
They go forward and reverse.
Buckle up, cause safety first.
Cars.
Where did I park my minivan? What?
Drive a truck, a big old truck, it's called a truck, cause it's a truck, a yellow truck, a purple truck, a green truck, yeah it's a truck, oh yeah! Drive a truck, drive a truck, give me those keys! Ba-ba-ba-boo, ba-ba-ba-boo. A truck, a look, a do. Drive a truck.
Drive a truck.
A big old truck.
A big old truck.
It's called a truck.
It's called a truck.
Cause it's a truck. Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Drive a truck.
Here we go.
Hooray.
Airplane, 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 up in the sky.
Up in the sky.
We can fly if we try. So high in an airplane.
Oh my.
So far, far, far up above the trees. We can cross oceans and seas. If you please, in an airplane.
Yes, please.
Looking down on roads and towns. Baseball fields, barnyards and cows. Canyons, castles, camping grounds. Swimming pools, grammar schools, come along and see.
is the conductor, and there's the engineer.
Hello.
In front's the locomotive, the caboose is in the rear.
Back here.
In the middle is the dining car for when you need a snack.
I'm hungry.
Roaring across the country, just hear those wheels clack.
Clack, clack.
Train ride, what do you see? Buffaloes on the wild prairie. Mountain lion and a big old tree, we're riding on a train.
Next stop, Pancake City.
The car's full of cans of beans, the flat car's hauling lumber. The sleeping car is for those long trips when you need to slumber. The observation car's windows are big so you can see. And the tank car, it is full of milk for making ice cream.
Yum.
Train ride, looky there, there goes a building, there goes a bear. See a moose and a lady in a rocking chair. We're riding on a train, we're riding on a train, we're riding on a train.
Did you see that moose?
No, I fell asleep in the dining car.